your vote gig?
Well, we just thought that we'd use the one thing that we can probably do well, play music, to help encourage young people to vote. Their vote is definitely important, so basically we're holding an event here at the Barge that young people be interested in to raise awareness so that they'll even think about voting, whereas if they didn't have an event like this, they mightn't want to. Because like, who wants to go to a town hall to hear about politics and stuff like that? You want to go to somewhere where you're going to have fun.
Has anyone here heard of Rock the Vote before? A few? Okay, I'll tell you about it. It was founded by artists and musicians 21 years ago in the US. It was founded by Madonna, let's see, Chuck D, anyone heard of them? Run DMC,
yeah.
Sheryl Crow, maybe, okay, I'm starting to gauge the audience here. Puffy. Okay, well, it was 20 years ago. But anyways, they started an organization, and the mission was to use their voice on stage from as artists, as musicians, to talk to their audience about why it matters to get involved and get them registered to vote first and foremost so that they could participate in our elections process. At that time, 20 years ago, the members of Congress in the US were trying to censor our music and decide what we could or couldn't listen to. Apparently there was some really bad rap music by this group called Two Live Crew, which actually wasn't very good, but it didn't mean that you could censor it. So artists, they started using their stage and their voice, and they started Rock the Vote. 20 years later, we're the largest youth organization in the US. We just came off a presidential election where we registered over 1 million young people to vote for the election. And we had the highest levels of youth turnout ever in our country for young people under the age of 30. So, thank you. And this time we worked with different artists, so slightly more modern. Who was that? Was it Grant? Was that his name? Who was just up here?
Yeah.
Grant? You reminded me of one of the young men we worked with. His name was Tyler from a band called Neon Trees. And Neon Trees went around with us, and before every presidential debate, they held huge concerts and brought tens of thousands of young people together so we could party and enjoy ourselves and also watch the debates together. We've also continued to tour the country with Lady Gaga. We continue to work with Madonna and many, many others. But the idea is to celebrate our democracy and our power as young people. And so we know, at least in the US, there are 46 million voters under the age of 30. We are 1 in 4 voters able to vote. And when we get registered and show up, we're able to make huge impacts. So we just learned on last Tuesday's election that President Obama would not have won the election if young people didn't turn out at the rates they did. They picked a president, and that's a major source of power. We also learned this time around that picking the president alone doesn't mean that we're gonna change the world, but it means that we have the power to do so. And so starting as soon as I got back from this trip, we're gonna be out there in the halls of Congress, we're gonna be in Washington, D.C., we're gonna be in city halls all across America, making sure that all of our politicians know, no matter how much money and no matter how much crap you try to do in D.C., there's enough of us and we're participating and we're gonna show you what we want our own America to look like. And I'm now touring the country, meeting young leaders like all of you, in different countries around the world, because I think that our generation is not just powerful in the US, but powerful if we work together across the world from country to country. So I'm gonna let you go back to the music, but check it out, Rock the Vote. I have some colleagues here from England as well who do a similar program there. I know that there's amazing work being done here by public achievement and youth action and all of you, so really honored to be here. Want to thank you for the work that you already are doing and encourage you to work with us so we can register youth around the world and make sure that this is the country and the future and the world that we want to be living in. So thank you again and have fun tonight.
It's about trying to raise awareness for people under 18 to be able to vote, and not just that, trying to raise awareness about voting itself, about the goods and the bads and what can offer me if I do vote. Also trying to, like, something about the laws, we're trying to get the laws lowered so we can vote younger.
I don't want to, but I feel obliged to, so yeah, I guess I'll have to vote. Right? Do I have to vote? Is there an option? Is it optional? No?
We're here because our youth group thought it would be a good idea to come here and learn about more young people like voting. And I think the speeches were very inspirational and like that make us think more about it.
I thoroughly enjoyed that last act. Those songs you wrote, man, fantastic. Nice work. Thanks very much for allowing me to come along to your event, guys. I'm sort of aspiring to do what all the organisations involved in tonight do back in England, and to get young people to believe in change. And I guess that's the whole point of what I wanted to say today, is that these events are the perfect start to mix entertainment with politics, and then to believe that we can truly take the energy from here and deliver a change that might not be instant, it might not be something that we will even see, but in generations to come, we might be able to hold our hands up and say, you know what, I was part of that, I started that. And for me, I truly believe that starts at the ballot box, but it also starts with rebranding politics. And we can do it by talking to each other, by sharing our views and opinions, and then taking them to our leaders and asking them to deliver. And if they don't, then it goes back to that belief again, belief that you're the right person to be the future leader. I think there's so many great organisations out there at the minute working hard to bring about a change, and they all believe it's down to you, young people, and I echo that. And I think if we can all collaborate and show that together, as Heather said from Rock the Vote, all around the world, we can show that young people actually can be in touch with each other and they can set about the future they want to live in. And it's fantastic. So keep doing what you're doing, and let's show everyone around the world that actually the power of young people is more powerful than anything they ever imagined. And it starts with that engagement. It starts with that belief. And it starts with exactly what you're doing here tonight. So once again, thanks very much for allowing me to come along, and congratulations.
People come around canvassing and a young person answers the door. They ask, are your parents in? And that immediately says to me they don't take the young person seriously. Whether they can vote or not, they should try to engage you. And I would challenge you, when people are coming to your doors to canvass in the next few years, have a few questions ready for them, and don't let them leave until they've given you answers to those questions.
I think the music like makes it more entertaining for young people, and like putting the speeches in between it is like a really good idea.
It's really good. All the acts are terrific, and the hosts that are doing the speeches are really inspirational. It's a really good evening.